Hey, what's up, everybody? Doren Aldana here, coming at you from the Art of Mortgage Marketing podcast with mortgagemarketingcoach.com. And today we're going to talk about three critical skills every mortgage professional needs to master for success. Without these three critical skills, you will forever be chasing your tail in the cul-de-sac of frustration. You'll be forever trudging through the mud with concrete blocks on your feet, doing it the hard way. You'll be forever being your own constraint, being your own bottleneck, and getting in your own way. And they're insidious and they're inconspicuous. And frankly, most mortgage professionals are completely clueless about these three skills when it comes to what it really takes to master the game of being a successful mortgage marketer. So I want to highlight them for you today. And these are the things that, frankly, your supervisor, your sales manager, your mortgage company owner, if you have one, is not on their radar about, so they can't give to you. They cannot give that which they do not have. So even if they wanted to give it, they couldn't because it's just not on their radar. It's not in their consciousness. It's not in their awareness. So even with their best intentions to serve you to your breakthrough and to serve you to your growth, they're unequipped and ill-equipped to be able to give you these because they just don't know them themselves, or they just don't have the clarity to be able to articulate it to you. So I've been in the game for 15 years, coaching mortgage professionals to success. I've seen time and time again, the frustration, the pain, the suffering works while you're not working. And these leads need to be relatively qualified, relatively hot for what you got. It's not enough to just have leads, is it? We also have to have them actually convert, which means they have to be pre-qualified or at least pre-sold to some degree so that you're not wasting too much time on people who are disengaged, apathetic, don't want to talk to you, not interested, and that sort of, you know, unqualified chaff that just chews up your time with fruitless toil. We don't want that. That's obviously a not great use of your time when all you're doing all day, every day is spending time with those kinds of people. Some of you can relate to that intimately, right? So lead generation isn't just about quantity. More importantly, it's about quality. And you and I both know the best quality of leads are by referral and repeat. So referrals from referral partners, like for example, top producing realtors who make you their exclusive. That's a big reason why people come to us for our expertise, is because we are the best in the business when it comes to a proven plan, a proven formula for getting top producing realtors hot for what you got, eager to meet with you and make you their exclusive, working on your terms, not theirs, sending you all their business and positioning you as irreplaceable and indispensable so you become the only logical choice. And here's the kicker: setting it up so that the realtor needs you more than you need them, right? How's that for flipping the script? Anything less, frankly, is doing it the hard way. So referrals from strategic referral partners, namely top producing realtors, is an excellent source of lead because they're already pre-sold. They're already hot for what you got, predisposed to work with you, and they're less likely to be rate conscious. They're less likely to shop you. They're less likely to, you know, drag their heels and not send you documents and not be compliant with whatever the process is and getting the loan done. They're much more likely to be compliant. And when you say jump, they say how high, because there's influence, because they trust you, because there's that endorsement power that builds trust. When that other person whom they know, like, and trust is endorsing you and recommending you, then you become that only logical choice. You become the authority, the expert, and the trusted source for them getting a mortgage, right? So that's one source. Another source is referrals from clients. It's one of the best sources of referrals, is someone who has already done a transaction with you and is a raving fan, even an evangelist, because of the phenomenal experience they got from you. So not all leads are created equal. You know that to be true. So what if we could get more quality leads, not just quantity, but quality? Obviously, that's the, you know, kicker. That's the absolute shortest path to the cash, to be able to get you making your cash register ring with more zeros and commas, is to get more quality leads. So that's the first skill, is mastering the art of getting more quality leads. It's not just an art, it's also a science. And you can do that the hard way by trying to reinvent the wheel, or you can lock in on a proven plan so you can condense, you know, decades into days, and instead of trying to figure out how to make a souffle from scratch without ever making a souffle before and wondering how the hell do I make a souffle, you get a proven recipe from a master chef who has mastered the art and science of how to create an exquisitely tasty, delicious souffle. And you can make a delicious, exquisitely tasty souffle on day one, on iteration one, on attempt one, because you have that recipe. So condensing those time frames is really powerful. And so finding a proven recipe or formula for success can absolutely condense those time frames. We're going to be talking about that as we proceed. That's the golden thread to success as well, is being able to get those formulas as opposed to trying to reinvent the wheel on your own to come up with those formulas. If you hadn't noticed by now, doing that is definitely doing it the hard way, because pioneers get arrows in their backs, right? I mean, if you're going to go out and try to reinvent the wheel, you're going to chew up so much time, energy, and money unnecessarily, because while you're doing that, someone's already done it. And so why not just get their proven formula? So with that being said, the second skill to master to be able to have long-term success in this business is lead conversion. So we've talked about the skill of lead generation and getting quality leads, qualified leads, hot for what you got leads. The next skill is to convert them, because it's not enough just to get a lead. You got to have authority. You've got to have expertise. You've got to have confidence and competence. You've got to be able to influence people to take certain steps to get to the outcome they want to get to. And if they're not willing to take those steps, or if you're not able to influence them to take those steps, then they're not going to cross the bridge into your influence and your solution, and they're going to go somewhere else, or they're going to do nothing. And fear or whatever the obstacle might be is going to stop them. So lead conversion is about having a formula, a system, a skill, a muscle, all of the influence power you can muster to be able to convert that lead into an actual closed deal. That's where the money is, right? You don't get paid on leads, you get paid on closings and volume. So that's where saleswomanship comes in, where you learn how to use the words that work to elicit trust, to find their pain, to find their needs and wants and desires, and to help them get what they want and to lead them. It's all about leadership. It's about trust. It's about influence. And those who have the most success with lead generation generally have the most success with lead conversion. Without lead conversion, lead generation is a moot point, because it's not going to actually amount to a hill of beans unless you're converting them. So the success of your lead generation is inextricably linked to the success of your lead conversion. And that means you need to be good on the phone. It means you need to be good in person if you're meeting with them face to face. It means you need to be able to take them from an initial conversation to taking the application and leading them through the process to getting them the realization of their dream, which is home ownership, which is getting that money out of their house or whatever it is you're helping them do. So lead conversion has many facets, many different dimensions of skill development. But the main skill there is salesmanship or saleswomanship and leadership, influence. It all comes down to influence. How effective are you at influencing someone to get the outcome they're looking for with the most expedient pathway, the most pleasurable, stress-free pathway to that outcome? If you can help people do that and give them an extraordinary positive experience, you're going to convert more leads into closings. If you can help them overcome objections, overcome things that are thwarting them from getting where they want to be, if you can help them get solutions for things that seem to be the bottleneck in the process or the thwarting point in the process, you're going to convert more of these leads into closings. So that's the second skill that you need to master for success as a mortgage professional, is lead conversion. What are you doing to master your lead conversion? Do you have the right scripts? Do you have the right drip campaigns? Do you have the right voicemail, text message, email campaigns? Do you have the words that work that elicit trust? Or are you repelling people because you're coming off as stuffy, dry, boring, too professional, coming across as a salesperson, coming across with commission breath halitosis, right? Are you repelling or are you attracting? Are you eliciting trust or are you just putting yourself in the same box as everyone else, as someone who's just trying to close a deal and make money? Are you connected to purpose? Are you connected to your purpose to touch hearts, change lives, and make a difference in people's lives? Or are you just connected to trying to make a commission and put dollars in your wallet? All of that makes a difference in lead conversion, okay? And again, one of the reasons why clients come to us, aside from cracking the code on their lead generation piece, is really owning the mindset and gaining the secret sauce mindset, skill set, scripts, campaigns, follow-up campaigns, drip campaigns, text messaging campaigns to maximize conversion on their leads. Because if you can keep your leads the same, but double the effectiveness of your lead conversion, you're doubling your income without necessarily getting any more leads. So there's huge leverage power in improving your lead conversion for obvious reasons. One of the easiest ways to give yourself an instant pay raise is double your effectiveness of converting the leads you're already generating. And a lot of mortgage professionals leave a shit ton of money on the table in their database just because they're dropping balls with their lead conversion. They have ineffective or non-existent follow-up. They have ineffective or flawed methods of trying to converse with these people that are repelling as opposed to attracting. They're leaving an absolute landmine, a field full of landmines of glitches and hitches that cause people to get derailed in the process and not submit the application, not submit the documents, not follow through. And all of a sudden now you're in frustration mode. And you feel like you're herding cats trying to get these people to do what you want them to do. All of those are symptoms of doing it the hard way and not having a proven recipe for optimal lead conversion. So there's an enormous amount of money that you can take off the table and put in your pocket when you master that skill, that art, that science of lead conversion. You guys with me on that? So that's the second skill, lead conversion. And lastly, the third skill that every mortgage professional must master to be able to master success in this business is self-leadership. Self-leadership. In other words, you are the source of your business. You are the source of your income. You are the source of the actions you take, the results you get. And that means that if you want to double or triple or quadruple or even quintuple your income, you have to double, triple, quadruple or even quintuple your ability to leverage your own influence of yourself to do actions differently so you can get results differently. You are the source. You don't double, triple, quadruple, quintuple your income just because you want it. You get it because you deserve it, because you're becoming a more productive, more attractive, more successful, more fruitful human being. You're becoming a better version of yourself. You don't get what you want, you get what you deserve. You don't merely get what you want, you get in inextricably proportional and inextricably reflected proportion to your value in the marketplace. I don't know what the heck I said. That didn't actually really make sense, but you get the idea, right? Your value is inextricably proportional to the income you earn. So the more income you have, it's proportional to the value you create in the marketplace. It's not proportional to your want or your desire or your need. It's proportional to the value you bring to the marketplace. And that value is 100% proportional to your ability to lead yourself into creating more value. You guys with me? So in other words, if you want to get more leads from realtors, part of the self-leadership equation in that is, what are you doing daily to attract top producing realtors to make you their exclusive? Do you have the proven plan? Do you have the recipe? Are you exercising and engaging and implementing the recipe? Do you have a daily method to push the needle of profit and performance in that area that's effective, that's a ritual and routine that's consistent. Because if you want to get champion level results, you can't afford to have chump level routines, right? So many people want the champion level result, but they're settling for a chump level routine and they wonder why they're frustrated. Be frustrated no longer, my friends. If you want to up-level your results, you got to up-level your routines. Our hopes are not enough. It all comes down to our habits. You can have lofty hopes, but our results in life will not rise to the level of our hopes. Our results in life will fall to the level of our habits. And so that comes down to self-leadership once again, doesn't it? That's why I say you're not in the mortgage business. You're in the marketing business. You're in the sales business. And then the third piece is you're in the success habit cultivation business, which means your job as a mortgage professional, if you want to be successful and thrive in this business, not just survive, your daily job is to cultivate success habits. Again, it's not about seeking perfection. We never attain perfection. That's an elusive butterfly. We're seeking progress. We seek progress, not perfection, right? How do we get that progress? We get it by cultivating success habits. What time do you go to bed at night? What time do you get up in the morning? What do you do for the first 3 hours of the day? Are you rolling out of bed at 7, going to bed late, watching, binge watching Netflix or binge watching sports channels? You know, the NBA finals are on right now. The NFL finals are on right now. A lot of people are, you know, lapping up the athletic competition. That's awesome. That's great. But what's your normal routine? Are you staying up late? Are you waking up late? Are you rolling out of bed, reading the newspaper, checking email, drinking a coffee, and just leisurely starting the day, getting sucked into the vortex of email and social media and scrolling through your Facebook? Or do you have a pre-planned champion level routine where you're going to bed a little earlier? Maybe you're reading something that inspires you. Novel concept, right? Turn off the Netflix and pick up a novel that inspires you, that uplifts you, that educates you. Go to bed earlier. Get up earlier. Go to the gym. Listen to something inspirational, motivational, educational while you're at the gym. I call it learn and burn. While your hands are busy, your mind is free. Are you visualizing your dream life as if you already have it? Are you affirming your identity as a champion, as a winner, as a goal crusher, as a dream achiever? Are you affirming who you see yourself to be as an overcomer, as a manifester, as someone who's successful, as someone who's influential, as someone who's victorious? Because your life and your results in life will rarely exceed that which you believe you're capable and worthy of. If you don't believe you're capable and worthy of doing 100 million, you'll never do it. If you don't believe you're capable and worthy of having a successful business, you'll never have it. If you don't believe you're successful and worthy of having a phenomenal team, you'll never have it. So it starts with the inside game, the inner game, self-leadership. What's your routine? What do you do in the first hour, 2 hours, 3 hours of the day? Are you priming the pump? Are you filling your tank? Are you getting yourself ignited and excited? Or are you just kind of dragging your butt through the day, trying to make it through the day and going with the path of least resistance? Do you have a champion level routine or do you have a chump level routine? Is your daily morning routine in sync with and a reflection of your defiant commitment to success? And if it's not, that's where you need to start. Up-level your game. And one of the reasons why people come to us is not just to up-level their lead generation, not just to up-level their lead conversion, but to up-level their self-leadership, to become a better version of themselves, to have coaches in their corner that can serve them to their greatness, serve them to their breakthrough, to up-level their daily routines, to have an energy orbit of champions, a circle of winners that inspire them to greatness. Because let's be real, this business can be very lonely, very isolating. You know, you're working from home or you're working from your own little cubicle and there's not a whole lot of support. Or if there is, that kind of support is not necessarily inspiring or motivating. It's kind of mediocre at best. And so you kind of feel lonely in an island unto yourself and you don't feel like you've got someone in your corner who's igniting you to become the champion you know you're capable of becoming. And rarely will the results in our life supersede or exceed the kind of associations that we have. If you want to be a champion, you can't afford to have associations with chumps who aren't up to anything, because those people will pull you down. Just like the crab that wants to, you know, the bucket of crabs. You probably heard this, right? There's a bucket full of crabs. And if one of them tries to crawl out of the bucket, the other ones pull it down. Well, that's what human beings do, because misery loves company. And when you try and crawl out of that bucket, it shines a light on their fear, on their sense of inadequacy, on the fact that they gave up on their dreams, on the fact that they couldn't make their dreams a reality. And if you win, it's going to expose their failure. It's going to expose the fact that they accepted failure and mediocrity and settled for a second best life. And so misery loves company. You've got to strategically surround yourself with people that inspire you to greatness, that celebrate your wins and victories, that pop the champagne, throw the confetti, and do the happy dance with you when you win, because you're winning and your victory is them winning. It's a reflection of them winning and their victory. When you win, it reminds them that they're on the path with you to victory, that they're part of your journey and you're part of their journey, and you're all marching towards conquering and taking new ground and making a difference in the world and achieving dreams. Those are the people you want to surround yourself with. Agreed? So those are the three critical skills, my friends, every mortgage professional needs to master for success: lead generation, lead conversion, and self-leadership. Now, if you're digging what I'm laying down, if you're picking up what I'm laying down and you'd like to get more information on how we can ignite you to your breakthrough, how we can be that secret sauce recipe to condense decades into days, how we can catapult you to that next level in your business and help you become the leader, the champion, the winner, the manifester you know you're called to be, I invite you to take advantage of a complimentary breakthrough coaching session with either myself or one of my consultants by going to mortgagemarketingcoach.com/apply. Again, that's mortgagemarketingcoach.com/apply. And this is only for mortgage professionals who want to increase their income by $100,000 or more, who are defiantly committed to winning, who have that whatever it takes mindset and are really up to something, who want to achieve big things, who are up to big things, who want to create a big, beautiful, bodacious, blessed legacy and are wanting to do it the smart way, not the hard way, and are just done with doing it the hard way, but are ready to step up to getting traction, making things happen, and creating breakthrough results. If that's you and you'd like to explore how we can help you do that and explore if we have the right fit to do that, then I invite you to take advantage of this complimentary call. We're going to lift up the hood on your business. We're going to look at what's working, what's not working, where you're at, where you'd like to be. If we can help you get there, by all means, we will show you how. And frankly, if not, we'll be the first people to advise you to pass on our services. Either way, though, you leave the call with massive value, massive clarity, and chances are we even have some fun. All right, guys. So if that sounds cool to you, I invite you to check it out. MortgageMarketingCoach.com/apply. This is Doren Aldana, the Mortgage Marketing Coach, coming at you from the Art of Mortgage Marketing podcast at mortgagemarketingcoach.com. Thank you for listening. Thank you for watching. I hope you found this helpful, insightful, useful. Now, go forth, engage, take action, take one piece of what I've shared today and apply it to your life, because the biggest gap in life is the gap between that which we know and that which we do. So bridge the gap between where you are and where you want to be by bridging the gap between that which you know and now what you do. Take massive action, bring massive positive energy to that action, and chances are you're going to get massive results, my friends. So let's do this. Let's take action. Let's make the dream happen. Thanks for watching. We'll talk to you soon. Peace.